everyone, welcome to Culture Corner. I'm Miss Ashley, and today we're going to go on a trip to explore the world around us. We're going to be traveling all the way to the continent of Asia to learn about India and Indian culture. I have a couple special friends who are going to be joining me to teach us about just some of the music, dances, and languages that are a part of Indian culture. Now, India is a big country with over 1.3 billion people living there. And in addition to that, people all over the world celebrate their Indian culture. With so many people, that means there's a lot of wonderful diversity in communities and cultures. So we're just going to scratch the surface on a few of the things that make Indian culture so unique. Oh, I think I see my friend Anand now.
Namaste. Mera naam Anand hai. My name is Anand. I'm here to represent India, and I'm going to teach you all a few phrases in the Indian languages. Then I'm going to demonstrate the tabla drum and play a little piece on the harmonium.
Namaste again. I'm here to introduce you to the Indian music, and here we have a harmonium, which you might think about as a portable piano. And I'm going to play a piece on it, which is known as Sare Jahan Se Achha, which is the national song of India. Percussion side of Indian music. So I'm going to play a piece. This is set to common time. It goes in multiples of four.
Great with music? Dancing! Let's learn about traditional Indian dancing with Saruchi. Maybe she'll even teach us a dance move or two.
Hi, my name is Saruchi Mathew, and I'm the creative director at Dancing Diva School of Indian Dance and Culture. We at Dancing Diva try to inculcate a passion towards various Indian dance forms through which we are kind of inculcating the creative expressions of all the students that we have. We at Dancing Diva have kids, we have teens, we have adults, and we have lots of kids with special needs too. We have been performing in and around Dallas and also at various other charity events, also at the State Fair of Texas. Last year, we won the international competition called the I Love Dance, where we got to win the folk and ethnic category in the first place, and also we were adjudged the judges' best trophy.
Today we are going to learn the basic foot movement, which is called the tippy toe. So for tippy toe, I'm going to keep my left on the ground and have my tippy toe on the right. And I need to go with a simultaneous movement, which is going to be 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Now try to incorporate your belly here, which will go like 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. Now with the little hand movements, I'm going to go with the little belly shake, which is very prominent and popular in all the Bollywood dances, which is going to be 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. And 1, 2. So for our next move, let's see how are we going to do with the foot movement. We're going to be a little bit inclined towards the diagonal. We are going to lift our right and cross over. So we are going to basically pushing our knee down and then go back. Down and back. Down and back. And little bouncing on the back feet. So we're going to go 1 and 2. 1 and 2. 1 and 2. 1 and 2. Now let's see the hand movements. Hand movements can be varied in these kind of steps, but let's learn the basic one, in which we'll have our left hand here and we are going to kind of make a rainbow from our right. So let's see. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2.
Indian dancing depicts a lot about the culture, rich culture, heritage and tradition of the country. It takes its deep roots in the form of 8 classical dances, which are basically woven, the choreography is basically woven around a story or a drama, and it's a discipline in itself. Then it's divided into basically all the folk dances, which comes from different regions and different states. Folk dances are very celebratory in the nature. They are always done on some special occasion, say a birth of a child, a wedding, or also kind of arrival of a new season. They have beautiful costuming done. They are basically accompanied with a lot of singing and also various musical instruments. Then we have the Bollywood dancing, which is very popular around the world. It's very appealing. The music is upbeat, rhythmic, and also it's very entertaining.
I hope you all must have enjoyed learning with me as much as I did dancing. So if you want to learn Indian dance forms, if you want to learn the very popular Bolly X, which is a Bollywood inspired fitness routine, please go to our Facebook page, Dancing Diva with Suruchi. You're going to get all the details there. Thank you.
Wow, wasn't that amazing? Dancing is such a great way to express yourself and your culture. Thanks, Suruchi, for sharing your talent with us. I sure do wish I knew how to say thank you in Hindi. Did you know that Hindi and English are the two most commonly spoken languages in India? I think Anand said he could teach us a few words in Hindi.
Okay, so we are going to learn a few of the Indian phrases. So the first phrase is Namaste, which means greetings. That's how you greet a person. You hold your hands and say Namaste or Namaskar. The next thing which you say is Aap kaise hain? How are you? Aap kaise hain? Okay, and you could say Aaj kaisa din hai? How was your day today? Aaj aapka din kaisa gaya? How are you doing today? Okay, so those are some of the phrases you could do. Okay, if you want to learn more, I represent Desi Roots School of Hindi Languages and Music, and these are some of our publications. You're welcome to visit our site www.discoverdesiroots.com. Dhanyavad, thank you. Alvida, goodbye.
Thank you for teaching us so many great words. I can't wait to practice them even more. Hey, I have one more idea. Why don't we all take a trip around India together? Oh, you don't have your passport? That's okay, come with me. Wow, we made it to our first stop. We're in East India in the Himalayan mountains. The Himalayas are some of the highest mountains in the entire world, and they provide water that runs through a lot of India, including the Ganges River. The Ganges River starts at a glacier in the Himalayas. It runs through the Gangetic Plains and then ends up emptying into the Bay of Bengal. The Ganges River provides water to millions of people living in India. And right now, we're standing outside of Varanasi, one of the oldest continuously inhabited cities in the entire world. Let's head up north to visit our next spot. Whew, that was quick! We're standing just outside of Agra at the Taj Mahal. the Taj Mahal is visited by millions of people each year. And in addition to being a World Heritage Site, it's one of the Seven Wonders of the World. It was built in 1632 by Emperor Shah Jahan as a mausoleum, or a burial site, for his wife, Mumtaz Mahal. It took 20 years to build and was made out of white marble. It's known as one of India's most admired pieces of artwork. Now, why don't we go over to the west for our next stop? Behind me is the city of Mumbai. Mumbai is the largest city in India, with over 20 million people living in and around it. It's also India's largest financial center and has the biggest port in the entire country. Mumbai also has a lot of extreme wealth and poverty. And in addition to that, has a lot of really important landmarks, like the Gateway to India. The Gateway of India is stationed along the waterfront and is built as a way to greet people and welcome them who are new to the city. Mumbai is also the home of Hindi cinema. Hindi cinema is based out of Mumbai and features movies filmed in Hindi that have a lot of action, comedy, romance, and dancing and singing. Looks like we made it to our final stop for the day. We are in South India near Periyar National Park. Periyar National Park is one of just hundreds of national parks found throughout India. This national park has over 300 miles of space that features a habitat for animals like hundreds of types of birds, reptiles, deer, bison, tigers, and more. It also has over 1,000 wild elephants in the park, which is India's highest population of wild elephants. Now, some Indian animals, like the king cobra, are endangered due to city expansion and poaching. And so these national parks provide a place for these animals to live. What a fun, quick tour throughout some of India's landscapes, landmarks, cities, and national parks. Thank you guys all for joining me as we began learning about India and Indian culture. And thank you to Anand and Suruchi for sharing your culture with us. Now, don't forget, this was just one small part of a big country and culture. To learn more, make sure to visit our website or come into the library to find resources about other cuisines and recipes, dances, music, clothing, and other elements of Indian culture. Have a great day, and namaste, friends!